You know, it's the contrast in life that I think make life interesting. It's the contrast in your friends, it's the contrast in your activity that gives you the balance that I needed to try to retain creativity.
He was an excellent storyteller.
They weren't necessarily architecture stories. They might be stories about La Jolla, his background, his involvement with Frank Lloyd Wright.
One of his great passions in life was fly fishing. And whenever he would get a package from L.L. Bean, I just remember on several occasions, these were waiters, I mean really high waiters in that. He couldn't wait. They'd be delivered to the office, he'd slip into them, and then he'd walk around the office with the waiters on.
You don't have to catch fish. You have to know how to cast a fly and have it go out and land just perfectly.
Say from the mid to late 60s into the early 70s, I think he, among others in the firm too, probably turned out some of his absolute greatest work. Muir College, your second college.
Very articulate in a way, but yet very modern.
Formwork, plant material, some of the vines on the building, the landforms.
A really pleasant experience of big concrete buildings. We're making living spaces, and not just one big goddamn mall.
The West Wing of the Fine Arts Gallery in that, there are these very unique shaped columns in that. And it's a very interesting grid because these spaces, both inside and out, could then be used for exhibition. The opening in the roof, into the courtyard, making that space very much alive.
Robert and Cal Straub and myself were standing in the Fine Arts Gallery, and Robert was pointing out all the things he didn't like, that he hadn't done it quite right, because he's a perfectionist. And Cal Straub said, "Rob, shut up, this is a beautiful building and I don't want to see what your errors were." I thought that was really cute.
The simplicity of the design, this very thin line as it crossed some relatively lengthy spans.
He was very proud of the fact that the color was picked by him, the form of the bridge was picked by him, and of course they worked together to determine how that arc had to take place in order to get the bridge high enough so the ships could get under it.
You know, it just kills me. I've built a number of buildings around town that people know, and when I'm introduced at a party, this is the architect who designed the Coronado Bridge.
I think a lot of people, as they would view the career of an architect, they would think, well, it has to be the buildings that he's done. But most of all, I think it was the people trying to leave the community better than what it was when he first touched it.
I kind of like the idea that my soul is a part of all of yours. And the thing that makes us love each other, care for each other, is that comradeship of souls.